नीचे दिए हुए लाल बटन पर क्लिक करके इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और घंटी के बटन को क्लिक करना ना भूलें। BKT मीडिया प्राइवेट लिमिटेड।
Namaskar and a very warm welcome to all you lovely people out there in this amazing and unique talk series, Chartered Accountants, The Growth Gears, presented by Committee for Members in Industry and Business, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. This is Shilpa Bhavna. I take all the privilege to be the bridge between my audience and the guest in every episode. So that means I'm going to be your host. Chartered Accountants, The Growth Gears. Why do we say The Growth Gears? Because they are the ones who ensures the proper implementations of all the laws and policies made by the government relating to the economy and ultimately for the development of the country. So my dear friends, Committee for Members in Industry and Business, ICAI, is going to make you meet all such personalities who have become chartered accountants and now they are becoming the growth gears for our economy.
Chartered accountants are very well known for having knowledge regarding how business is set up, how it is run competitively to make profits not only for its investors, but also to contribute to the government through taxes and to pay back to the society through CSR and by creating multiple employment generation options and many more. These are the reasons which make chartered accountants the growth bearers towards nation and economy in true sense.
Today we are going to meet a chartered accountant who with his vision and talent has changed the skyline of Mumbai. Or I should say across India. My dear friends, get ready to meet the entrepreneur, co-founder and the managing director of Hiranandani Group, CA Niranjan Hiranandani.
Born on 8th March 1950, Niranjan Hiranandani is a real estate entrepreneur of India. He is a co-founder and managing director of the Hiranandani Group, one of the most premium real estate developers of the country. A chartered accountant from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and a doctorate in philosophy, Niranjan Hiranandani is among the 100 richest Indians ranked by Forbes. He's been one of the top 10 Indian real estate tycoons. Carrying a friendly smile with a golden heart and the thirst to learn and acquire new heights, CA Niranjan Hiranandani is one of the finest idols of leadership. Hold your breath. We are entering the world of Hiranandani.
Welcome to this talk series.
My pleasure, and thank you for asking me to join this series. It's a pleasure and privilege.
So, most of the people, they know you as the real estate tycoon. But I would say that this is not the just one feather to your cap. You wear a lot of caps as well with many of the feathers. So would you just like to tell us that when was the time when you just realized that I now need to take up the chartered accountancy as like my degree or into my profession, because you don't have that family background. You have a medical family background.
Yeah, my father was a famous ENT surgeon, Padma Bhushan, Dhanvantri Award winner. And everyone in my family was either a doctor or in service. So really, I took up something quite different and I did my commerce in, from Mumbai in Sydenham College. At the end of it, I wanted to get into business directly. CA was not even in my mind. But there's a friend of my father, a very famous person, Mr. Nani Palkhiwala. He was a lawyer. My father took me to him. He asked me, young man, what have you done? So I said, I did my BCom. How did you do? I said, I stood second at the University of Mumbai.
Oh, that's quite
so
great.
So he said, now what do you want to do? He said, I said, I want to get into the business. No, 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 Mr. Nani Palkhiwala said, you must do chartered accountancy. That's where the future is and you are going to do.
So they actually have written your future into this CA fraternity.
Absolutely. And I never thought of it at that point of time. And I thought I would really not to any professional studies, but I did, and I'm happy for it.
Yeah, so I would like to know that why you are happy for it today. When you look back, do you see that chartered accountancy degree helping you out in your entrepreneurship as well?
Of course it does. The discipline of being a chartered accountant is extremely important.
Oh, very nice.
Because you not only learn, but you also understand how disciplined one must be with money or with the way you actually deal with business. And I do believe that it gives you a kind of a sound grounding in terms of how money is dealt with, and also how the nuances of that happens, finance, doing mergers and acquisitions, the growth story of what
the
you
bigger
need
to, aspects.
The bigger aspects of it, the nuances of it. And I think all these changes have taken place. There's a second part to it, which I think a chartered accountant's degree has been very important. And that is what our institute is all about, which is continuous learning.
Right.
The requirement for a chartered accountant who is holding a certificate of practice or otherwise to actually continuously learn.
Right.
Let's say I passed my degree 40 plus years ago.
Yeah.
And when I did, I had a certain grounding of knowledge. But everything has changed. The income tax law has changed. GST has come into force. Various other funding options
and
are available.
It's not just once. It keeps on changing.
It keeps on changing. So the grounding of a chartered accountant is continuous. The institute itself gives you a plus plus all the time. So you can relate with it. You can upgrade your skills.
Right.
And I think that is the crux of the entire chartered accountancy degree.
If I'm not wrong, you were also in the teaching faculty at Institute of Chartered Accountants of India.
That's right. In the first 2 years after I did my chartered accountancy, I taught for 2 years in the Institute of Chartered Accountants for final students, and I was a good teacher.
Yeah. When you have the knowledge about a certain profession, then you gain confidence. This is how you are also saying that that degree also helped you in this entrepreneurship. So being a millennial on Forbes and then giving back to society, how does that relate to your heart?
Well, that's part of me. I think many years ago, my father mentioned when we were building a township that, you know, when you make money, you should start a school. I took my father's words and we started building the first school the same year.
Okay.
And within 18 months, the school was up. It's a beautiful school which has done extremely well and rated as one of the best schools in Mumbai.
Gee.
But it brought me into giving back to society very quickly. I run 14 colleges in Mumbai with 45,000 students. We have 6 schools. 2 are quite famous. The others are for poor people. So we run that, which must be having about 15,000-16,000 students.
So sometimes you still go over there and teach them the discipline that you have been taught at ICAI?
Well, I love teaching and I still speak to students at least once a fortnight, if not once a week.
That's great.
I still do that, and I love that part of me, and I'm called not only for my own schools and colleges, but also for others. Last year, the government of Maharashtra has given me a separate cluster university. So I'm now a head of a university in Mumbai, a separate one.
Wow.
And so education is a part of my life too. And we also have a skill development center for the poorest of the poor. We do about 5,000 people whom we train for various skills.
Skills.
Very poor people.
How do you see this particular CA profession different from other professions, as in like legal or like other aspects related to it? How do you see that difference, and what advantage do you see that a CA professional has over the others?
Well, simply speaking, in common parlance, one would say that when you have to deal with money, which becomes the common flow in all businesses that you can possibly have. Everything has a bottom line in terms of money transactions, which ultimately are the cause of everything.
Of course.
And the CA degree really talks about all this in a very professional manner. Second, it's got a syllabus which gives you an updated position which brings you up to speed with what is useful to you as a professional,
right,
as well as an entrepreneur. Me as a small businessman in real estate in the initial stages, we had no funding available from the formal sector.
Okay.
Look at the fast forward today. Today, you would get bank funding.
Of course.
You would get private equity funding.
Hmm.
You would get REITs. You would get InvITs. You would get IPOs. You would get foreign direct investments. You would get listing on various exchanges. Hmm. So the funding options have increased over a period of years.
Okay.
As a chartered accountant, one would be able to take a judgment call much easier and probably more rational if you understood and had a background of the accountancy profession.
Right.
So I think it is an advantage to have all these things, not necessary, but advantage.
Yes.
You know, especially when you ask me the difference, I'm reminded by a quote from Ratan Tata when he made a speech in one of the institutes, I think it was on the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India some time back, when he said, to run my business, to run the entrepreneur part of it, I need MBAs. But to operate and run the business, I need chartered accountants.
Oh, God.
So I think the core of the entire item is really very important. And if you look at the top people today, let's take TCS, one of the companies in the country. The CEO of TCS is a chartered accountant.
Yes.
So I think, you know, we have both the leadership options available to a chartered accountant and also the operating part of it.
Right.
So I think it's a combination of both, and we should relish the fact that the profession gives you that opportunity of rising above the others in a very easier manner than it would be if I didn't have my degree. Right.
In the Chartered Accountancy course, we teach our students accounts to help board of directors. We also teach them corporate laws to help the board ensure legal compliance. We teach them direct and indirect taxes to help them adhere to tax formalities of the land. We teach them audit to help management and stakeholders ensure fairness in the business transactions. We also teach them costing to help management remain competitive in the industry. The course also teaches them strategic financial management subjects to make our professionals best financial advisors for business. This makes our members a complete business solution provider.
Emerging as a destination for global investments, India is surging ahead as a vibrant economy. As an integral part of this growth story, chartered accountants are considered to be the growth gears of the economy.
Chartered accountants are considered to be the best visionary persons because they know how the things are being turned up and how it is not only within our country but across the globe. As a professional chartered accountant, one built all the qualities to understand and analyze what is meant for him. If we talk about CA Niranjan Hiranandani, he has been grown like in the manner ki he well understood with what is the need of the society, what is the need of the industry. It is not this segment only as segment of the real estate. Whatsoever the wherever the chartered accountants are there as an industrialist or the entrepreneur, whether it is the stock market or the different industrial segments, they have really been outperformed. They are bringing the name of this profession to the world, ki who can do anything bigger. It's the profession of the chartered accountancy because of the strength of the knowledge, strength of the minds, and naturally the taking little risk also along with it.
The cornerstone of the chartered accountancy profession was laid in 1949 by an act of parliament with the establishment of a statutory body called the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, or the ICAI. The ICAI plays a pivotal role as partner in nation building and development of the country.
The chartered accountancy course training itself is a very rigorous training where you learn how to do the business, even how to do the practice, how to manage the accounts and finance. Simultaneously, since the training is such that how to do the business, what SOPs are there for the purpose of doing the business. That makes ultimately a difference in the life of the students when he passes the chartered accountancy and he gets three options: either start his own practice or join some industry, or may start a startup or a business.
Sir, I would like to ask you, because you are running an empire, right? So if an aspirant of entrepreneurship who is also holding a degree of chartered accountancy, what traits would you say that are required for like his or for him or her to be on a successful ground?
Difficult to say. One thing definitely which is required is fire in the belly.
Yes, the passion.
Yeah, the passion, yeah. The desire to want to do something, you know.
Yes.
We normally have a glass ceiling, which is usually a mental ceiling, not a real ceiling. Aap itna hi kar sakte hain. Isse aage koi gaya hi nahi hai.
Koi gaya hi nahi hai.
Kisi ne nahi kiya. Aap kaise kar sakenge?
I want to do it if no one else has done it.
Yes.
That desire you need.
So that feeling should be there in the mind and body and heart. And there are plenty in India who have that.
Yes.
So that's the beauty of it. And India is a land of entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. So if you can mix an entrepreneurship talent in that with the fire in the belly and a professional career, you cannot but succeed.
Tamannao se nahi milte khwahishon ke shahar. चलना भी जरूरी है मंजिल को पाने के लिए.
सही बात है. यू डोंट टेक फर्स्ट स्टेप देन यू कैन नॉट रीच. वंस यू क्रिएट अ बेसलाइन ऑफ अ प्रोफेशनल डिग्री, ऑल द अदर थिंग्स कैन बी ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट. मल्टी स्किलिंग, वुड यू बी एबल टू स्पीक वेल लाइक यू डू, कम्युनिकेशन, बीइंग एबल टू हैव नेगोशिएशन स्किल्स, स्किल्स टू बी एबल टू ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप्स, ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इट कैन देन बी पुट ऑन top of the first base that you have created.
Right.
Take the profession also. The profession, you could be an auditor, you can be a tax expert, you can do M&As, you can do forensic. So even in the profession of chartered accountancy, there are lots of professional options to do. And plus you can do professional and you can also be a profession in industry. So options are plenty.
Sir, what's lying in the future for you?
I have lots of dreams. So it's not just one, it's multiple townships to create. My son has gone into data centers. We do gas pipelines. But the other more interesting part is the not-for-profit work that I do. So I want to expand my university. I want to do online and distance education. I'm putting up a school of yoga.
Oh.
A school of real estate we have just started.
That's unique, sir. It is going to be a so much good learning for the people who would like to join this real estate industry.
So a school of dance and music and performing arts, maybe you will join.
Yeah. I was about to say that I can be a part of that.
Okay.
So, I'm a passionate dancer, I must tell you.
Fantastic. So that's what we are planning, a digital learning. Basically, we have a hospital. We want to expand it. We are now going to do heart transplants, LVAD, which would be a substitute for heart and lung machine, which will be implanted in your body. These are just immediately in my mind, which I can share with you. And hopefully we can have many more things that I can do because I'm only 71.
Only 71.
That's right.
And as you said, that you have many dreams.
Yes.
So dreams are important.
Yes. I do believe that God has fixed a time when you're born and you go. But what you have in between, you should make the most of it. Because every second is precious, because that is the only thing in life which is limited.
And I must say, sir, you are actually utilizing this time in the best possible way, because I haven't seen anyone only at 71 and working so much. You only have 24 hours as we do have. So today, if I ask you that if you have to say any three things to those aspirants who are just ready to get that degree of chartered accountancy, what would you say?
I think you got to dream, but with the dream, you have to take the first step. The second thing I would suggest is that you got to improve 1% every day.
Every day?
Every day.
Yes.
So if I have done this interaction with you, next time when you meet me and we have an interaction, it's my commitment to you that the interaction will be at least 1% better.
Beautiful. That's
so
a great
thing, this cannot
thing,
be the best.
Yeah.
You have to keep on improving yourself into do it.
That's great.
And the third, you have to work not only with your mind, but also your heart.
Ah, that's very important.
At the end of the day, if you don't have your heart in the thing, you can't put in so much. If I don't love speaking to you, I don't have the time to do it.
So respecting your time, sir, thank you so much for giving us this precious time for this candid interview. And there are so many things that you have told that I think all the aspiring chartered accountants, say professionals, they are going to learn a lot from this. Thank you so much for joining us in this Chartered Accountants, the Growth Gears. I must say that you are also one of the Growth Gears.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Friends, Chartered Accountancy is one of the toughest exams in India to clear. But you know, when we hear the success stories from the personalities like CA Niranjan Hiranandani ji, it really gives us a boost. It makes us understand that there is nothing difficult in this world. To surpass all the difficulties, we just need perfect dedication, and along with that, that fire in the belly that Mr. Hiranandani was talking about. The Committee for Members in Industry and Business, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, would like to make you meet more such personalities who have reached the ladder of success and excellence and who are an inspiration for all of us. See you soon again. This is Shilpa Bhavna signing off for today. Jai Hind!